Today is Wednesday, the 18th of October, the feast of St. Luke the Evangelist.
Christ has no body now but yours, no hands, no feet on earth but yours. Yours are the eyes through which he looks, compassion on this world. Yours are the feet which he walks to do good. Yours are the hands with which he blesses all the world. Yours are the body now but yours, no hands, no feet on earth but yours. Yours are the eyes through which he looks, compassion on this world. Christ has no body now on earth.
Today's reading is from the Gospel of Luke.
After this, the Lord appointed 70 others and sent them on ahead of him in pairs to every town and place where he himself intended to go. He said to them, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, ask the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest. Go on your way. See, I am sending you out like lambs into the midst of wolves. Carry no purse, no bag, no sandals, and greet no one on the road. Whatever house you enter, first say, 'Peace to this house.' And if anyone is there who shares in peace, your peace will rest on that person. But if not, it will return to you. Remain in the same house, eating and drinking whatever they provide, for the laborer deserves to be paid. Do not move from house to house. Whenever you enter a town and its people welcome you, eat what is set before you. Cure the sick who are there and say to them, 'The kingdom of God has come near to you.'"
If I see myself as a Christian, as a disciple of Jesus, it's easy to think that my job is to bring God to people. But in these words of Jesus, there's a reminder that wherever I go, whoever I encounter, God has been there before me. When I meet people, when I talk, listen, converse with them, Do I recognize that God is already present and active in their lives? The kingdom of God has come near to you. Have I ever spoken those words or words like them to anyone? Would I put it some other way? Would I want to say it at all? How, in these terms, every encounter between human beings is potentially a precious moment of grace. What grace do I feel I most need from God as this prayer time draws to a close? It may be a greater awareness of God's presence in other people, or God's help to communicate better with others, or maybe something else altogether. Whatever it is, knowing that God loves me, I will ask with confidence for what I need. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.